Getting an aviation medical is the first step to becoming a pilot, but the process can be confusing. In this video, I'm going to tell you everything you need to know about the aviation medical, including vision requirements, and take you step by step through the process. Welcome, aviators! Glad to see you back, ready to consume some aviation content. If you're new here, my name is Yaro and I take the mystery out of the aviation industry, so consider subscribing so you don't miss any of my future videos. This week I'm going to break down the aviation medical in Canada. We will talk about the different types of medicals you can get, where to get them, vision requirements, and give you an idea of what to expect when you show up to the doctor's office. Let's get into it. So let's start with, why do you even need an aviation medical? Pilots operate complicated machinery thousands of feet in the air, so to be able to have that privilege, you need to pass a thorough medical examination. Not only that, but your and your passengers' lives depend on you being in proper health. Also, your medical is what actually keeps your pilot's license valid. If your medical expires, you cannot use the privileges of your pilot's license. Because not everybody wants to become an airline pilot, four categories of medicals were developed. The first is a Category 4 medical, and that is mainly for recreational pilots who just want to fly as a hobby. Next, you have a Category 3 medical, that is for private pilots, Category 2 medical for air traffic controllers, and finally you have the Category 1 medical, and that is for commercial pilots. All of these medicals have different testing criteria and expiration dates, so it's important to get the right medical for the type of flying that you are going to do. If your goal is to be a pilot as a career, then you should do the Category 1 medical, and this will tell you right away if you're medically fit to be a commercial pilot. There is no need to get the Category 3 medical and then the Category 1 medical, as the Category 1 medical has the highest testing criteria. Now that you know what type of category medical you need, where do you find a doctor? A Category 4 medical can be done by any doctor, but a Category 3 and 1 medical can only be done by a Transport Canada approved aviation doctor. I will link the Transport Canada website in the description below, where you can find all the aviation doctors in your area. Once you find the closest doctor, just phone to set up an appointment, tell them the type of medical that you need, and they will tell you exactly what to bring. The cost varies from doctor to doctor, but expect to pay around $120 for a Category 1 medical. If you are thinking about the aviation career but are having doubts about your health, this is a small price to pay to get some answers. An aviation doctor will be able to tell you if there's anything holding you back from becoming a pilot, and that's why you should do your medical first, before starting the flight training and spending the big bucks. So once your appointment is booked, what can you expect when you show up to the doctor's office? Well, the first step is just like any new doctor's office, where you get a long form to fill out with all of your details. After that, you are sent to give a urine sample, so make sure not to use the bathroom before showing up to the doctor's office, and drink lots of water. All they are testing for is any unusual proteins or sugars in your urine. In Canada, your urine is not drug tested. If you are concerned about marijuana, since that's legal in Canada, check out this video. Once it's your turn to see the doctor, you typically start with some questions about you and your family's history, followed by an eye test. This is the most common myth, that pilots need to have perfect vision, and that's simply not true. Many pilots wear glasses or contacts, and some even choose to get laser eye surgery. If you do laser eye surgery though, you might lose your medical for up to 6 months, so take that into consideration. For distance, you need to be able to see 20/30, either corrected or uncorrected, and that is the third line from the bottom of the chart. If you want to practice at home, just print a chart from the internet and stand 20 feet away from it. For close vision, you need to be able to read the Jaeger eye chart about 30 to 50 centimeters away from you. Next, the doctor will test whether you have any color blindness by reading Ishihara plates. It tests color perception for red and green color deficiencies. Here is what they look like. Let me know down in the comments below which card doesn't have a number in it. If everything is good with your eyes, the doctor will move on to your ears. He will check inside of your ears and then make sure you can hear loud noises by normal conversation and quiet noises by him speaking quietly in a corner and you repeating what he is saying. For the very first medical, your ears will also need to be tested on a pure tone audiometer. Some doctors have this machine, others will send you to a lab where they put you in a soundproof booth and sounds of different frequencies are played into each ear. Next, he will do a physical exam on your body, check your reflexes and your balance. Another question is whether you can be a pilot with diabetes, and although I can't answer this conclusively, there are conditions under which you can be a commercial pilot, so I suggest you consult your doctor and get a Category 1 medical done to make sure. Next, they will record your height and weight, and lastly, test your heart. Again, for the very first medical, you need to pass an electrocardiograph, and the doctor should have this machine at their office. And that's it. The aviation medical seems like a daunting task, but it's quite simple. The average person should have nothing to worry about and will be able to pass the medical no problem. Very few people actually fail, but if you do, you might be lucky enough to have discovered a condition that went undiagnosed. I'm not a medical professional, so if you have questions or doubts, contact your aviation doctor. I'm also going to link everything I talked about in this video from the official Transport Canada website about what is included in the aviation medical if you want to read it in more detail. A pilot's health is extremely important. It's what allows us to keep flying, so always keep that in mind. A good diet and exercise is a must for longevity in this career. Your eyes and ears are your biggest assets and should also be protected, so consider investing in a good pair of sunglasses for your eyes and a noise-canceling headset for your ears. So I hope this video gave you the information you needed to be able to get through your aviation medical successfully. Thank you to the patrons who support this channel and keep these videos coming. Smash like if you enjoyed this video, subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video. We'll be right back.